السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. We present to you lesson number 1051 of our daily nasiha and advice. Our topic today is the places to visit in Saudi Arabia. We all know that Makkah Mukarrama, Madinah Munawwara are the holiest places for Muslims throughout the world according to the Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And thereafter comes Masjidul Aqsa in Palestine in Jerusalem. However, in Saudi Arabia there are many other places a person could visit. Number one, Ta'if. Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the initial stages went to Taif after majority of the people of Makkah did not accept the message or the messenger, Allah forbid. So there in Taif we find there was a person, Addas, and he gave Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam some water and grapes. He embraced Islam also, hence there's a masjid they call Masjid Addas. Likewise, the most famous masjid in Taif is Masjid Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, the senior companion of Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is known as Ra'isul Mufassirin, one of the greatest commentators of the Noble Quran. He is buried there and his masjid is in front. So one should visit these places when you visit Taif. Likewise, one should try and go to Tabuk. By plane, it will take you 1.5 hour, 1.25 hour from Medina to Tabuk or Jeddah to Tabuk. There in Tabuk, in the 9th year, Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, 30,000 Sahaba went there, and there's a masjid there as well where Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam performed salat. And there also, you will find not far from there a place called Ula, U-L-A. And you can stay there, and from there you go to Madain-e-Salih. Madain-e-Salih is that place where Almighty Allah sent Nabi Salih alayhi salatu salam wa ila Thamuda akhahum Saliha to the Qawm-e Thamud. And they were proud and arrogant people. They rejected the message and the messenger and said that from that mountain tell your Allah to produce a she-camel. Allah called it Naqatullah, the she-camel of Allah. So they rejected Allah, they rejected Nabi Musa alayhi salam. Allah Ta'ala punished them. So if a person goes there, it must not be for entertainment and fun, but for Ibra, to take lesson. So all these places are nearby. Likewise, in the 7th year of the Hijrah, in the month of Muharram, the Battle of Khaybar took place against the Jews. So it's about 150 kilometers away from Madina Munawwara there in Khaybar. So you can visit there as well. The forts are still there. How Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu played a pivotal role there. And Allah gave victory to the Muslims against the Jews. Similarly, a person can visit Badr as well. And that is on way and route to Makkah, Medina, or Makkah to Medina, whichever way you are going. You take the old road. And there the 14 Sahaba who are Shaheed are buried there. And this was the first battle in Islam. May Almighty Allah Jalla wa Ala grant them the highest stages in Jannah. And Uhud is just outside Medina Munawwara, and that most people know about. Thereafter, you go to Khandaq, that is the trench, that is also on the outskirts of Medina Munawwara. Hudaybiyah, when you are about to enter Makkah Mukarramah, just before the Haram starts, there's a board showing Shumaysiyah. So that area, Shumaysiyah, is Hudaybiyah. So try and visit that as well. The masjid there is called Masjid Hudaybiyah. Likewise, that the person should also try and visit, in Makkah Mukarrama, the museum, which is very, very interesting, and you will find many things there. You don't need a guide because everything is written in Arabic and English. Likewise, in Medina Munawwara, the Mujamma Malik Fahad is there. The Quranic complex, millions of Quran Sharif have been printed there and distributed free. So that also is very, very informative, mashallah. We all should make dua, Allah mahfaz bilad al-haramain al-sharifain min kulli su'in makruh. Ya Allah, protect the haramain sharifain from all the enemies. Allah matahir al-majid al-aqsa min al-yahud al-ghasibin al-muhtalin. Ya Allah, protect majid al-aqsa from the enemies. Barakallahu fiqh. Salaamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.